Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. New scientific reports are providing spectacular details on the Comet Siding Spring's close encounter with the planet Mars. According to NASA investigators, the effects of the encounter on the Martian magnetosphere were as dramatic as they were surprising. In October of 2014, the comet passed within 87,000 miles of the red planet, and scientists with NASA's Maven mission were amazed at the effects on Mars's upper atmosphere. Maven team member Jared Espl-ey said in a recent statement, "We think the encounter blew away part of Mars's upper atmosphere, much like a strong solar storm would. The main action took place during the comet's closest approach, but the planet's magnetosphere began to feel some effects as soon as it entered the outer edge of the comet's coma." A statement from the Maven team reads, "A Mars comet flyby caused a merging of magnetic fields from the comet and Mars. NASA was in the right place at the right time and was able to study what happens to a planet when a comet comes extremely close to a planet." Earlier NASA reports had described the cometary encounter adding a, quote, "very strong layer of ions to the ionosphere of Mars." The electrical model of comets predicts an electrical exchange between Comet Siding Spring and the planet Mars. When the coma of the comet touched the magnetosphere of the planet, and the two bodies could, quote, "see each other electrically for the first time," the magnetic disturbances in cometary ions in the Martian ionosphere were due to the electric current flowing between the two bodies. However, these events can only seem mysterious to comet scientists, since the current, standard comet model still characterizes comets as dirty snowballs. We are still told that a comet's most dramatic phenomena, including the production of the familiar jets and coma, are the result of ices sublimating on the comet nucleus due to solar heating. In this model, solar heating produces a comet's coma, which interacts with a solar wind to create a cometary magnetosphere. However, both the most recent findings on the plasma environment of Comet 67P and countless enduring mysteries of comets dating back many decades point to a much more dynamical electrical nature of comets. Comets have produced outbursts, or in some instances, even disintegrated or exploded while vast distances from the sun, much too far to explain the events by solar heating. Conversely, numerous comets have survived seemingly impossibly close encounters with the sun. This includes the Lovejoy comet C2011W3, whose nucleus survived intact after about 1 hour in the extraordinary conditions of the sun's corona. In the electric universe, comets acquire a, quote, "negative charge with respect to the sun in their time at the outer reaches of the solar system." Cometary activity increases as the comet experiences a rapidly rising voltage differential in its environment. A comet will begin to electrically discharge when the electric field at the nucleus exceeds the breakdown voltage of surface atoms. This can happen suddenly when the comet's plasma sheath or coma hits a plasma boundary in the solar wind, or that of a planet's magnetosphere or plasmasphere. It was this understanding that led the Thunderbolts Project's chief science advisor, Wal Thornhill, to successfully predict the advanced electrical flash that stunned NASA investigators when an 800-pound copper projectile collided with the comet Temple 1 in 2005. For a profound demonstration of a comet experiencing a dramatic voltage spike, let us look back again to the comet Shoemaker-Levy 9's encounter with Jupiter in 1994. At the time, astronomers were predicting that the encounter would be as trivial as pebbles falling into an ocean. However, the energetic effects of the comet fragments were astronomically greater than anything comet scientists had anticipated. As reported by Sky and Telescope, when Fragment A hit the giant planet, it threw up a fireball so unexpectedly bright that it seemed to knock the world's astronomical community off its feet. The Hubble Space Telescope detected a flare-up of Fragment G of Shoemaker-Levy while the fragment was some 2.3 million miles away from Jupiter. Then, with the impact of tiny Fragment A, Hubble detected unusually energized auroral activity. Radiation belts were disrupted, and unexpectedly bright X-ray emissions occurred. Why would a minuscule impactor provoke an explosion of electron activity on the solar system's largest gas giant? Another mystery arose as well. It happened that the Galileo spacecraft was positioned 150 million miles away from Jupiter, at an angle that gave it a ringside seat for arrival of the first fragments of the comet. But the impact of the first fragments would be hidden from Earth behind Jupiter's limb. So it was a major surprise when our Earth-based observatories actually saw some of the, quote, impacts start at the same time Galileo did. That means the explosion actually began well before the first fragments physically hit Jupiter. Just as in the advanced electrical flash prior to the impact at Comet Temple 1 in 2005. Mission scientists said at the time, in effect, we are seeing something we didn't think we had any right to see. It seems clear that something was happening high enough to be seen beyond the curve of the planet. In a recent five-part video compilation, Dr. Franklin Anariba, a specialist in electrochemistry, offered his extensive analysis of several papers from the Rosetta mission to Comet 67P. Among the findings Dr. Anariba discussed was the discovery of electric fields and fast-moving electrons surprisingly close to the comet nucleus, and the evidence that electrochemical processes via electron stripping may be responsible for the production of water molecules in the comet's coma. While such processes are not yet part of the astronomical lexicon, we do see the beginnings of recognition in the published literature of surprisingly dynamic electrical comet activity. In a Rosetta paper on the electron environment of the comet, the authors state that fast-moving electrons, quote, are accelerated by an unknown mechanism from a few electron volts upward to hundreds of electron volts, and play an important role in the electron-neutral chemistry as well as in dust grain charging. However, as Dr. Anariba has stated, from an electrical perspective, electron acceleration is due to the point charge sitting in an electric field, which is an indication of the presence of a voltage differential. Yet the concept of objects such as comets experiencing, quote, voltage differentials is not well developed nor understood in astronomical circles. In contrast, the concepts of the electric universe dispose of earlier concepts such as charge neutrality in space. The electrical phenomena associated with comets may be critical in advancing astronomy to a better understanding of our electric universe.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.